Nice to see you again. Well, actually, nice to read your comments. I mean, first let me take a sip of wine. And then let's talk about Airbnb. Why Airbnb? Because for me, honestly, it became a lifestyle. For the past 3 years, I've been living exclusively, not exclusively, but mostly in Airbnbs. And the reason for that, you guess it? Yes, the cost. The cost was probably the main reason, which allowed me actually to afford this lifestyle of being living in different countries, in different places, and different cities across the world. And I've been across Eastern Europe, across Western Europe, in Mexico, in US, in Airbnbs. So I have some experience in that area. I mean, I have not stayed in every single area possible with Airbnbs, probably like varies from place to place. But I have some general experience about that platform, so I just wanted to share it with you. So my first Airbnb experience started in 2013. The reason for that experience was because I was researching for places to stay in New York, the city of New York, I researched the hotels. And I wanted to stay long term there. Because I wanted to stay long term, of course I researched different options, but the price was like $7,000 per something between 3 weeks and 4 weeks. I don't remember exactly, but let's say like months. That price was to me like shocking. Crazy price. Who would want to pay $6,000 or $7,000 for a month of stay in the hotels? So I was thinking, wow, that's crazy. I don't want to pay that much. Of course, you can research in the Craigslist, you can find some options there, you can do that. But honestly, if you want to stay for a month and you don't want to do that much research just to be able to stay in some same place, and yes, there are hostels, but god damn it, I mean, staying in a hostel for a month, it's gonna be like tragedy for me. And back then, in those times, I was not even able to stay in hostels. I was really like, not really comfortable with this lifestyle. Right now, I'm fine. I can stay in hostels from time to time. But back then, I was like, no hostels ever for me. Yes. So that's when I started searching for alternatives. The alternative that came up was the Fresh platform that was actually started in summer 2010, I think. So Airbnb just started back then. And I was looking for a place to stay there. And to my surprise, a room in Brooklyn was around like $1,500 compared to $7,000. It was, come on, it was like perfect price. I would like, honestly, like willing to pay that price. So I actually booked that stay in Brooklyn for a room nearby the subway station. And it turned out really well. I stayed in the family. It was a nice family. Neighborhood was kind of a bit sketchy, I would say. But at the same time, it was still like a good experience. Like nothing bad happened to me. I've enjoyed it every day. So it was great. And New York subways, you know, this like works 24/7. So for that reason, it worked really well for me. So I enjoyed my stay in New York. And then I've stayed like from time to time, like twice maybe a year or three times a year in Airbnbs. And I've enjoyed it. Then I've decided like, hey, how about just like living that lifestyle? At that time, I actually quit my job in 2017. And started to like looking for options to stay in somewhere for long term. I was thinking about volunteering. I'm still like fine with this idea of volunteering, but the thing is that yes, volunteering is cool, but at the same time you can earn much more money if you just like do something and stay in a nice place without somebody like mandatory doing work for somebody. So I love the idea of volunteering, but honestly, still, like, even if you, like, let's say, teach English or something, it's much better to, like, rent your own place and stay that way than volunteering for me, for now, actually. It's a good option when you don't have money at the moment and you just want to have some ability to travel the world, but if you want to have some good experience and you're willing to pay the money for it, then I think it's Airbnb is a good option. So yeah, I've stayed in Mexico for 6 months, and every 2 weeks or every 4 weeks, depending on the place, I was moving around different apartments. And I started in Mexico City, and then Querétaro, then Puerto Vallarta, some other places, yeah, Tijuana actually. And then I was like, wow, I can actually live that way. That's how my 2018 went. I was living like half a year in different places. Yeah, of course, I've stayed also in other places, like my parents' house for a while, just for a few months, just to store my stuff. But yeah, no, honestly, I just like threw away all my mostly all my stuff that I had. So my idea was getting rid of those possessions, and I was able to do that. So like living that way in Mexico made me feel like, yes, I can actually live that lifestyle. And that changed me a lot. So staying at Airbnb is a good option. You can try that. I really like this option, so you can actually try this as well. Why not? If you like that video, please guys, subscribe, press the like button, and see your comments down below.